nobody ask what I had to do or what it took to get these stupid sheep up here. Welcome everybody to episode 52. It has been a hot minute since our last episode. It's been like 2 weeks. I got really busy with finals, but now classes are done for a while and I'm here to play. So I got sheep up here and they're eating all the grass faster than it can grow. But this is what it looks like when it's working. I do that, then this should push them up within reach of me grabbing all the wool. And then when I get back, they should have some more wool for me. And I can just breed them if I ever want. Yo, check this out. I don't know if this has changed. Oh, I can't. There's one of these white sheep that I can't dye green. Like, I'll dye green, and then I'll cut his fur or his wool, and it'll be white. And then it'll grow back white. And then it spits out the dye. Like, I get the dye back. It's really strange. If it grows back, I'll see if I can get it. So I also did some work up here. I have the jump boost on, so that's why I'm jumping so high. This guy's still not dead. This is supposed to be enough of a drop, or I thought it was enough of a drop, to kill this guy. And I had a creeper come down and not die, so I moved up another block, and apparently it's still not enough, so let's just do one of those. So I've worked on a dropper. And I say worked on because it's not done, and it's not really working particularly well. Let's take a climb up here and look. Right now, I've built 3 layers, and 2 of them are functioning. The top one is exposed sunlight, so it's not working. And I sat around for a little while to see if anything would spawn, and it's really not. I don't know if it's a combination of the fact that I only have 2 layers and I guess I just haven't lit up the caves well enough yet, but things really not spawning very well. So this is what the pads look like, and then there's a layer on top of it, 2 blocks ahead, so only 2 block tall mobs can spawn, no endermen, and there's slabs in the middle because that prevents spiders to spawn, which would clog up the system because it's only a 1 wide. If you want spiders in it, then you can always, you'd have to expand these canals to be 2 wide. So it would just take some modifications, it would be bigger, but it would fit. And then the idea of this whole thing is that it will be covered up somehow by this temple when the temple goes up. Right now it's kind of just a big eyesore. Ooh, let's see if this guy's the guy that refuses to be green. Is it you? So if I do that, no, that's not him. It must be him. We ran out of our test die. Anyways, so like I said, it's been a while since our last episode here, right? Like 2 weeks, a week and a half. And I'd been struggling with working on the temple in particular around here. Working on these huts, I could get on for hours and just build these huts, these yurts, as I've found that they're called, all day. But there's not much variation to them. It's really not challenging me as a builder. This is. But I just don't even know how I want to go about this. So instead of sitting around here episode after episode and waiting for an idea to come to me, we're actually going to head back to the farming village for a few episodes and see if we can finish up that place. If you remember, it's not so far off from being finished, so we're gonna do some work there and then, you know, just kind of see what we're feeling. It's not gonna do anyone any good to be sitting around here waiting for inspiration to come and just building out this thing and then sitting back later and thinking, I really don't like this. So that's kind of the point that I wanted to be able to have when I started multiple projects, that I can leave this place and go work on another one. So let's grab some food. Got a little extra. I've stocked all this stuff with the stuff from here that I feel like I need. And I'm going to leave my beacon behind. You know, this thing's really nice. I don't know if I showed you this because I don't think I've put this on camera, but I put that thing on haste, and I have an efficiency 5 pickaxe now. I just plowed right through this in like a couple minutes, and now I have a bunch of stone, so if I ever need stone, I know where to come to. Once again. So we're back in the farming village. It actually feels kind of weird being back here. Some of you may not know this place very well if you've only recently joined me. And the reason it feels a little weird to me, is because this place was not built in vanilla texture pack. The first good while in this Let's Play was in John Smith texture pack, and that's what this was built in. And now whenever I come here in vanilla texture pack, it makes me realize that my building without the fancy textures and stuff kind of leave a little bit to be desired. I could maybe add some stuff on this wall. It's very plain. Let's go into the texture pack and see what it looks like. I am in 1.11, which, and that's a 1.10 texture pack, which 1.11.1 came out, which would be the first update for the next major update. And it's got like, you can put armor and stuff that you get from zombies into a furnace and get ingots out of them, right? So that's cool. Kind of got used for all that scrap armor now. So yeah, this is what the place was originally intended to look like. And I think I'm going to stay like this. I don't know if I want to stay like this or not, because I think I'll stay like this for this area. Because this is how this place was intended to look. That looks really cool off in the distance with the fog. So I've actually done a bit of work. I'm going to take you inside to show you some of the work that I've done. Ooh, I'm getting some little leg spikes. I've noticed, by the way, if you ever get like seemingly inexplicable leg spikes where you'll be walking around and then it'll just kind of drop frame rates, go into your task manager. Sometimes Minecraft opens a second thing of Java, and I'm not really sure what it is, and I can end it, and it stops that, and it doesn't seem to affect anything by ending it. So, anyways, this room, if you remember, this room was completed. This is like the committee room. It's not really much of a throne room because this is a farmer's guild. It's not like, not really a king. I finished this balcony up here, and there's no real good way to get up there yet. This is my way of getting up here. So this room is very, unfinished, but the room itself is more or less finished. When I came back here, I kind of realized, you know, we have our library down here, and it's not finished. The idea was that these bookshelves would go to the ceiling, and I really don't like this room. We might have to do something about it sometime. I don't know. Let's get some food on us, yeah? There we go. It's so weird being back in John Smith texture pack after not being in it for so long. I have my volume so far up right now. So most of my work that I've done, and this is why I want to show off this episode, I want to get the exterior of this place finished off. So, where is there a zombie around here? No, these are lit up. I have no idea where there would be a zombie. This wall, or there was nothing here, so I built this little walkway coming up here. Still got to do this, and then put this tower into place. Not done, but it's the exact same as that. And then brought these walls over here. So that just leaves us with, let's come up here. All we really need to do is figure out how we want to bring back the roof here. So that's going to be pretty straightforward. That can just probably be straight back, I'm guessing. And then the wall is going to be right around here. And I'm not really sure how I want to do it. And it's not really, I don't know. The interior is giving me headaches too. I'm not really sure. That's kind of like a low priority thing right now. I'm tired of dinking around with the interior and then feeling like I'm not getting much done on the exterior. I'd rather get the exterior done first and then worry about the interior. Here's a little thing. By the way, if you haven't seen, I put up a creative build where it's like a Nordic inspired bolt hall turned upside down, and then they use that as a roof. And I came up with this cool little flag design where basically I didn't have a light in the other one, but I was like, well, I need a lamp. So I tried like your traditional lamp where you have it go straight up across and then have a lamp hanging. I don't like that. I really don't. It's like too bulky. It looks weird. So I put a lamp, and that's a daylight sensor. And it looks like it's actually turned on. Either it's on, or since I'm using an outdated texture pack, maybe it just shows that it's on. Looks like my texture pack is indeed outdated. Or maybe that's glowstone, because I think they're textured the same. I don't remember what I put up there. But then I surround it with the flag colors. And the original idea was that it's like a new kind of flag where it's draped over something instead of your typical banner flag or waving flag. So that's a cool idea, I thought. I just want to kind of go over some things here on these houses because realizing that they're a little bland in some places. Some of them are all right. Like this is okay with the double window, I think. I learned a few things. I put up a new video recently where it's a build study of someone else's build, where basically I copy their build and then figure out what they do that I don't do. And I did learn some new tricks there. Definitely learned some new tricks. If you're an advanced builder that's looking to get some new techniques, then that would be a very good series for you. What could we do here? Could we do something like, oh, you gotta have a block under that, don't you? Yes. So I think I mentioned before, but I am officially done. Do you have to like actually, there it is. I'm officially done with this semester of classes, which means I don't like that. It means that I have some free time, but with the free time, I'm going on vacation visiting family, so I'm getting some recording done. I haven't been doing a whole lot of recording because of school. Like this past month was pretty slow, and now I'm getting back into it. Trying to find what house was I looking at? That was so dull. See, they don't look nearly as dull now as this house. This house looks awful. So let's do a double. Oh, you know what we could do? Check this out to give it a shutter look. Let's do this. And then that doesn't actually swing closed, but I kind of but still looking at that straight on, I don't it doesn't add much. I think it would be better if we just did it this way. So yeah, I'm going on vacation for about 8 days, I think, or something. Not vacation, but I'm seeing family. I guess it's vacation. And some of these places, I don't really like this frame. Some of these could be revised a little bit. These are pretty simple houses. I'd like to do an area where the houses aren't so simple, because the yurts in the jungle village are even more simple than this. I mean, there's more variety to them. I really like the way that they look, but there's like not a whole lot to them. I'm thinking about putting up some videos of Astroneer, which I see a lot of people doing. I'm just kind of looking at what I got here. Sorry, I got some milk coughs. Yes, I drink milk still. I'm a milk drinker. I don't know why I say still. Lots of people drink milk, right? We've got lots of hay bales, so this place will look nice when we finish all these houses. Yeah, anyways, Astroneer. I'm getting so sidetracked. Astroneer, if that's something that you're interested in and you want to see your favorite YouTube personality, which is me, right, play some of it, then keep your eyes out for that. And I'll definitely, I think I bought it, so I think that I'm gonna be doing a series of it. But not much more Minecraft for the next like week or week and a half. I don't know, depends on when this goes up, right? That's where I had my beacon. So we're pretty much finished here. We got a good, I did get a good bit of work. I know I didn't do anything on camera really, but I did get a good bit of work done on this. Let's actually fly around it. Game mode 1, fly on up. I really like the layout of this. It'll really help. This chunk is still here. If you didn't see this episode or you weren't with me for this episode, my world got corrupted at some point and a few chunks like swapped places. Like I think this chunk belonged like over here somewhere, right? And there was a chunk. This building got like torn in half. It wasn't finished anyway, but this some of what was finished got destroyed and right here. And you can actually see right here. Oh, you can't see with this texture pack, I don't think. If I were to go to the regular texture pack and you could see the differences in water by biome, you'd see like a square of different colored water because it thinks it's there's one chunk of plain there from when everything got, so you can see exactly where this chunk is, like right there. It's funny. I gotta fix this still. I kind of wish it didn't screw up this house over here though. This one right here. I think it would help this place a lot to have something along here, so we'll work on that. Oh, here's something that I did. I was always very unhappy with this wall right here. And what it was, I added this line of roof trim or whatever, and it made it 100 times better to me. It just, I think what the issue was the first floor was like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 blocks high, and then this wall was 2, and then a roof line. So I brought this down. And it looks much better. I'm much happier with that. Like, that was ruining the whole build to me. This whole place. There's, like, a few random blocks, like, right there. Like, does that need to be there, I wonder? I kind of want to know. What can I get rid of? I'm not cheating, I swear. Let's just get rid of these doors. I get rid of so many doors. Yeah, that didn't even need to be there. I'm not sure why that was there. But there's stuff, like, there and there where they had to be that way. That's something that I need to learn how to work with. When you've got interior that doesn't mesh well with exterior, do you just leave it like that? Like, do I just leave that stone exposed? But yeah, look at it from this way. It's like, it looks like it's done, right? Just gotta pull that roof back and then add a wall to it. I just don't know what I want to do for this wall. And I can't take out too far because we do have our campsite back here. But it's getting there. So thank you for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed. Not sure where we're going to be going next. I'm probably going to finish this and then maybe work on these houses. And maybe a new area. I know that jungle area. Here's the thing. That jungle area, it's good. I like the houses. I don't know what to do with the temple, and I'm not going to sit around here not doing anything. I'm not going to sit around there not doing anything, so it makes more sense to me to start a third area and do something more fun there. I really like this area. I really do. Anyways, guys, yeah, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed it, leave a like and subscribe. I appreciate it. Bye!